So my friend Jacob has installed 23 kilowatts worth of solar on his roof, which generates an insane 120 kilowatt hours worth of energy every single day. For reference, the average home in the USA uses only 30.
Average home only uses 30?
Yeah.
Good. I don't know where all mine's going.
During the day, he has so much excess power, but at night, when the sun turns off, he ain't got nothing. If only there was a way to capture that excess energy during the day and use it at night when the sun is gone. And thanks to my channel sponsor, Anker, whole home battery backup has just become a whole lot easier and cheaper. Anker has a brand new stackable battery power wall system called the Anker Solx X1. It's an extreme energy performance storage system. And if you ignore the snowblower strapped to the ceiling, you can see some perfectly good wall space for us to mount them today. A Solx X1 power wall is made up of two parts. A power module that sits on top that can output 6 kilowatts of power, and then the modular battery module sitting beneath it. Each battery module adds 5 kilowatt hours worth of backup capacity to the house. With solar energy being the cheapest energy source in the world, it just makes sense to add batteries to hold that sunlight through the night. For Jacob's house, we're using 2 stacks, giving us a total of 12 kilowatts of power and 20 kilowatt hours worth of capacity. More than enough to get him through the dark winter nights and effectively making his house an off-grid oasis. Each stack of batteries can either be floor mounted or wall mounted, and we chose to mount them to the wall. So each of these battery modules is 5 kilowatt hours, and we can stack up to 3 tall. This is the brains of the whole operation, and it can output about 6 kilowatts worth of juice. We will have 2 stacks of batteries for a total of 12 kilowatts of power, each stack having 2 modules, which is about 20 kilowatt hours. Each of the batteries have these little feet on top, and these feet, combined with the French cleats, are gonna sit right here on this rack, with the French cleats falling down into these grooves. And they look pretty awesome. Sitting at just 5.9 inches thick, they can mount very flush with the wall, and they have a pretty cool light bar that illuminates when someone walks by. Getting them mounted to the wall was actually pretty easy. Now let's get the whole house plugged into the battery banks. The nice thing about the Anker Solx X1 is that it doesn't require a specialized technician. Any certified electrician familiar with battery storage can knock this out in about a day. These batteries provide 100% power from -4 degrees all the way to 131 degrees. And to be honest, if you live outside those temperature ranges, you should probably consider moving anyway.
Yeah.
The hardest part of this whole operation is going to be at the main control panel, since this is the whole home backup instead of a partial backup. We have to put the Anker Solx X1 panel in between the utility meter and the regular home panel, so that if the power ever does go out, the Solx X1 can initiate its backup abilities in less than 20 milliseconds. This panel also brings up to 6 battery stacks together and allows them to charge off the solar panels, turning Jacob's house into the microgrid that doesn't need civilization anymore. It's also smart enough to preemptively charge up to 100% when there's a storm coming, and we can talk more about that later. Anker's energy optimizer inside of the power modules also allows old batteries and new batteries to be used together inside the stacks, so you can expand your system whenever you might need to. All the way up to 36 kilowatts of power and 180 kilowatt hours of capacity. And since each of the batteries have a 10-year warranty, there's plenty of time to expand in the future if you need to. The whole stack is IP65 and can withstand rain and dust, but I'm not gonna be the one to test that. Walking up to the batteries, they just both turned on just barely because I knew I was walking towards them. So So the battery is charging right now, 96%, and the home is using 1.3 kilowatts. Here in the Anker Solx X1 app, we can see how much solar is being generated, as well as how much power is going into the battery. And it keeps track with some pretty interesting graphs. We have our total power generation, how much power the home is using, our discharge capacity, as well as our net power consumption. And if you look at the month of like how much energy Jacob's system is generating, 1,741 kilowatt hours, which is some ridiculously massive numbers. That's also with a few rainy and cloudy days, and we're only halfway through the month, but having that many solar panels attached to this battery system just shows how powerful it can become. If you look right here, it says on grid, and we have a white light illuminating from underneath the display. Jacob's gonna take us off grid by disconnecting the house from the utility. And now there's a blue light underneath. Super interesting. It says we are off grid. The home is using about 2 kilowatts, and the battery is going to power the house for about 10 hours. The Anker Solx X1 has 3 different energy modes. There's self-powered mode, which maximizes green energy use. There's time of use mode, which helps customers charge their batteries while electricity prices are low or if they don't have solar. And the new mode called NEM 3.0. which allows people with the Solx X1 to sell electricity as fast as possible while the price is high. Currently only available in California, but it basically turns the Anker Solx X1 into an employee. We've set up the shop light here because Anker says that when we switch to off-grid mode or like in an emergency situation, it takes less than 20 milliseconds to switch. So we'll see if this shop light flickers when we go to off-grid. Jacob, hit the button. The light stayed on. Every single plug and every single light, every single appliance in this whole house is currently attached to these batteries. The blue lights indicate that we are completely off-grid. Let's see what happens when I plug in my truck, though. Now all the juice from the wall-mounted battery is flowing over to my truck, pulling 11 kilowatts. It'll be nice that Jacob can still charge an electric vehicle while the grid is down. If you listen really closely, you can hear a slight hum as the batteries are charging and discharging. But in the grand scheme of things, it is basically non-existent, especially when you consider other home backups like a gas-powered generator, which would be infinitely louder. All right, so Jacob, now that you've been using it for about 3 weeks, what are your thoughts on the system?
So initially, I was a little reluctant to let it cycle every day, just to wear them out. Coming with a 10-year warranty, that means I've still got another 3,629 days left.
Of like full cycles, right?
Yeah, for that's with cycling every day.
That's wild.
Not too worried about that. Great to offset a little bit of power, and then have plenty of juice in any kind of power goes out, emergency situation, turn a few things off and I can be totally off grid.
Yeah, so Jacob's setup is a little bit over the top, but if you're looking for a battery backup solution for your home, I'll leave a link down in the description for the Anker Solx X1. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.